Welcome to the last video on sculpting our character. Today we will finish him. Yay! It has been quite a journey. Our character is almost finished. It remains only to finalize the details. I'm creating a more natural hand and body joint, although it won't be seen at all. Next, we will make wings from the same petal. Again, I scale it, rotate and place it at the back of the character. As always, using the mirror modifier. I don't want wings to clip with her necklace too much on the animation stage, so I'm sculpting them both, trying to give more space for the wings to move. Refining wings shape. As you can see, a good topology helps me a lot in this case. It would be much longer and harder to sculpt a clean shape like this without a nice topology. Refining legs shapes. Let's make a flower for her hair. I will copy some parts of the necklace and position them in the shape of flower. I'm then adding a sphere to finish in the flower. Select all flower parts and press Ctrl plus J to join them in the one object. And now let's use Snap tool. Choose Snap to Face and align rotation to the target. Also, don't forget to press Rotate button at the bottom of drop-down menu. Finally, press G and place the flower at her head. I am moving flower petals so they are not clipping with the character's head. I tried to give a new flower slightly different shapes for interest. I'm switching between mask by face sets, on or off in the brush settings, and working on the shapes of the petals. I'm moving her antennas more at the top of her head. I feel like this placement looks much better. I'm making a copy of her leg and creating the sting for her, but she has no booty, so I decided to sculpt it, adding a sphere, as always remeshing it, and start sculpting a booty. I will assign a dark material so she doesn't look naked and doesn't make me blush in front of you. working on her tummy. I think she looks like a cute bean. I am sculpting this part of the body very roughly, since it will be seen rarely. And to be honest, I want to finish this character already. But nonetheless, I keep thinking about human anatomy. I'm deepening her skirt. Working some more on her body. I'm bouncing back to wings, and I want her wings to be smoother inside. So I'm selecting faces and then using smooth vertices in the vertex menu and adjusting the smoothing amount. And again, it was effortless with the nice topology we have here. Scaling her sting and placing it better. Working on her dress. Working on her flower a bit more and adding a proper material to the central part. Now let's finish her hand, remeshing and refining it, gently working on her thumb. back to her flower. Adding the mirror modifier, sculpting them. I want to ensure that they lay beautifully on her head, so I'm moving and rotating them and trying to fit them better. I even tried to make a flower headband, but I didn't really like how it looked, too much noise, so I created just a standard one from a path curve. And I added some details to make it a bit more interesting. Sculpting her hairband. For some reason, faces were inverted, so I pressed Alt plus N and choose Flip to flip face normals. Final touches here and there. And she's done! Unbelievable! She looks like a simple character, but it took a long time to finish the sculpt. And here is the final result. In the next part, we will move on to retopology. See you very soon!